Hey there everybody, it's Renee here, Low-Key Geek, with another video, this time for all you gamers out there, especially you PlayStation 5 gamers, if you're lucky enough to have one, that is. It is June 13th, and today is the big day, because the newly revamped PlayStation Plus program has launched officially on the PlayStation Network. So if you are not familiar with what all of this means, prior to today, there was a subscription service that PlayStation offered gamers on their PlayStation 4s and PlayStation 5s that allows you to pay a yearly subscription where it gives you the ability to obviously play games online with your friends, give you exclusive discounts, and gives you free games to download every month. Those were like some of the major benefits. And they also had a PlayStation Now service that allowed you to kind of do more cloud gaming. They allowed you kind of a library of games that you could play online through the cloud. So what they decided to do is combine the two and make it one ultimate experience. A la like what the Xbox Game Pass is doing for the Xbox and PC. But what they did today, they decided to tier it out, make it affordable for those who want certain benefits or for those of you who want the whole shebang. So here in the Americas, this service or these new tiers have launched today. Asian markets, you guys had already the opportunity to play around with this and test it out on your end. But for those of you who are in the Americas, you get to finally experience it today. For those of you who are in Europe, Australia, New Zealand, you won't get to see this until June 22nd. So maybe this video can give you a little insight as to what you might be able to expect. Now, as far as the pricing is concerned, you PlayStation Plus members prior to today won't see much of a difference, maybe a slight bump in your subscription fee, depending on how early on you were able to renew or got into the program. It is now called PlayStation Plus Essential. As you could kind of see on the screen right now, it kind of categorizes me as essential because I am already currently a PlayStation Plus member. I had my subscription pretty much renew itself every January. And obviously, we are now in June, so I am halfway through my subscription for the year. So it is now called PlayStation Plus Essential, and the pricing for that is $9.99 monthly, $24.99 quarterly, and $59.99 yearly. Now, there's a second tier called PlayStation Plus Extra. Now, what that does, it gives you everything that Essential has, plus it adds a catalog of somewhere around 400 PS4 and PS5 games, including what they call blockbuster hits. Now, pricing for that here in the US is $14.99 monthly, $39.99 quarterly, and $99.99 yearly. Now, if you want the whole shebang, you can go forward and get yourself that PlayStation Plus Premium, which again includes everything that I mentioned in the previous tiers. Plus, it adds an additional, like roughly around 340 games. Those include PlayStation 3 games that are available through their cloud streaming service, and a catalog of beloved classics that you may have remembered from the days of the original PlayStation, PlayStation 2, and PSP. In addition to all of that, you also get the ability to try out some time-limited game trials, which will be offered in this tier. And those are usually for the latest new releases. They've already mentioned, so the one thing that they did already mention that is very different from Xbox Game Pass is that a lot of the new games that are coming out, especially the current gen PlayStation 5 games, will not be available to fully play on their service, and more than likely they are going to be timed trials. So it's not something that's going to be included in the catalog with your subscription immediately. Maybe give it like a year or two, they may add it on later on. But unlike Xbox Game Pass, a lot of their first tier and main games have been made available to play day one on Game Pass. And if you've watched the recent Xbox and Bethesda online, I don't know if you want to call it a conference or panel or presentation, let's call it a presentation, that aired over the weekend, pretty much the majority of the games that are coming out within the next 12 months will be made available to play on Game Pass day one. So that's the little difference here. But if you wanted to go the whole shebang route here with the premium, here in the United States, you'll be paying $17.99 monthly, $49.99 quarterly, and $119.99 yearly. So in other select markets, they do have something called the PlayStation Plus Deluxe. So those are for markets without cloud streaming, because cloud streaming is not available in all markets right now. So for those without cloud streaming, PlayStation Plus Deluxe will be offered at a lower price compared to premium, and includes a catalog of beloved classics, games from the original PlayStation, PS2, and PSP generations to download and play, along with time-limited game trials. And all the benefits that are included already in Essential and Extra tiers. So let's just dive in to see like what to expect when you log into your console. Like I said, I'm already a PlayStation Plus subscriber, so I've already been kind of tiered into the Essential tier. Now, if you go to the PlayStation Plus selection here on your menu, you'll see this new screen here that shows up saying, you know, introducing the all new PlayStation Plus. If you scroll down, you get to see they give you kind of like options to explore. You'll see this upgrade button right away, but let's not get into that right away just now. But it gives you some examples of titles you could play. Now, what they added here now is you'll see a new icon that hovers right above the titles of each of these games, and it will tell you what is available for your current subscription and what is available for premium or what have you. So these two games, for example, I can play already through Essential, and this is something that's only available through premium as of right now. What I like here is that this really breaks it down to you for you as to what you get per tier. So like I said before, under premium, you get the game trials, right? Test drive some of the latest and greatest. You get the classics catalog, right? Enjoy past hits from the vault. And cloud streaming. Stream hundreds of PlayStation Plus catalog games. Extra, you get the PlayStation Plus game catalog. So this is additional games that you will have access to once you upgrade. Now for Essential, which is the normal current PlayStation Plus subscription that most of you already have, a lot of this shouldn't be new to you. So you do get the PlayStation Plus collection, which is a curated selection of essential games that they deemed must-play games on the PlayStation, right? And most of them are primarily PlayStation 4 games, with some of them having the ability to upgrade to their PlayStation 5 versions. You get every month, you get the chance to download selected games that they provide. You get exclusive discounts, you get some nice DLC sometimes, you get to enjoy online multiplayer, cloud storage, and so on and so forth. So let's take a look into what is available for Extra. Let's say you wanted to go in and maybe you don't want to commit to the full premium just yet. So if you click on View Games here, they break it out by genre. So let's go Featured right now. And these are some of the games you can expect to play once you upgrade to Extra. And you can see the little icon that's now hovering above the title where it says Extra. Some of these you might say is already installed because I already have that in my library. But for example, here's Assassin's Creed Valhalla. You have Doom, Far Cry 5, Ghost Runner, Final Fantasy X and X2, and a few other titles that will be available to you. Now, if we go back and let's look into action, these are some of the action tiles you are able to play once you upgrade to Extra. So you have Miles Morales, which is a current gen game that they have. Demon Souls, which is, again, current gen. Ghost of Tsushima, which you can play here. This is the Director's Cut version. You have the Death Stranding Director's Cut here that has been upgraded for PS5. Now, this is the thing that I'm a little disappointed about. You have the Spider-Man Game of the Year edition, but only the PS4 version, which is interesting. It doesn't look like they give you the access to the PS5 upgraded one. You have God of War. Now, this is a little confusing because it says premium, but it should be available. The PS4 edition, at least, should be available. You have Control, Days Gone. Let's go through some of these other titles here. Maneater, which is one of my favorites. Hello Neighbor, Ghost Runner, like I said before. You have Infamous First Light, Secret Neighbor, Uncharted 4. And so on and so forth. So, you know, a good amount of titles here to choose from under this genre of action. Not so bad, right? All right, so let's take a look at what we have. On, if you are a sports fan, this is what you have available to you. So you have 2K, you have NBA 2K22, Steep, WRC, Monster Truck, and the rest you see on the screen. Under Adventure, you have Detroit Become Human. Now, again, it says premium here, but it should be available to you under Extra. Sniper Elite, Call of Cthulhu, Shenmue 3. Let's see what else we got here. Yeah, it's decent stuff. I wouldn't say anything that blows my mind. Nothing that you'll go, you know, nuts over, really. But some good options there. Now, we also have shooters. So, I think one of the best options you have is Returnal. Returnal is a current gen game that you could play. Shadow Warrior, Wolfenstein. Let's see. A nice throwback here, Wild Guns. And that's about it. Driving and Racing. You have the classic, The Crew. Trials. GRP. Okay, not much. Under RPG. Again, Ghost of Tsushima. You have a good selection of Final Fantasy titles, as you could see on the screen there. Battle Chasers. And yeah, that's pretty much what you got there. For puzzles, Valiant Hearts, Marvel Puzzle Quest, Tetris Effect, and Res Infinite. Go down here, Kids and Family, Overcooked 2, which is a fantastic game to play with a group. Little Big Planet 3, a nice classic there. You have some Lego games to choose from. No, I should just say a Lego game to choose from. Bubsy, you know, so some stuff for the family and the kids. Under the fighting genre, you have Naruto Storm 4, Mortal Kombat 11, Injustice 2, Soul Calibur, Dead or Alive, you know, so some decent stuff here as well. Under Simulation, that's your jam. You have City Skylines, Lawn Mowing Simulator, Tropico 5, so some good stuff there. And under Strategy, Evil Genius 2, which I've been dying to try out because I was a huge fan of the original. Desperados 3, John Wick Hex, Star Trek Bridge Crew, and the rest you can see on the screen right there. And then they have like some must-play stuff here, which are games that I've already covered through the other genres. Now, next here, don't get fooled by this, because this says Classics Catalog. Now remember, the Classics Catalog is only available if you are a premium subscriber. So everything under this section will only be available to premium subscribers. Same goes for the PS3 section. All of the titles that you see here are only available for premium members. So let's go through the PS3. So you have God of War Ascension, Resident Evil 4, God of War 2. Yeah, it's interesting. Let's see if there's a way I could sort this better for everyone. Let's sort by A to Z. All right. Alone in the Dark. There you go. That's a good title. Asura's Wrath. Love that game. You have Batman Arkham Origins. You have some of the Bionic Commando Rearmed games. Cars games. Castlevania. You have a good amount of Castlevania games from the PS3 days. Darkstalkers Resurrections. Some Dead or Alive. Devil May Cry. You have the HD Collection and Devil May Cry 4. Disgaea 3 and 4. ND2. Epic Mickey 2. The Double Dragon Neon. Dragon's Lair. And Dragon's Lair 2 Time Warp. Such fun games to play. You have a lot of Dynasty Warriors. For you Dynasty Warriors fans out there, you are covered. So you got a good amount of stuff there to play or replay. Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas. Let's see. Ghostbusters Sanctum of Slime. Great game. And like I said, God of War. So you have the God of War collection here. So you could go back and relive those or play them for the first time. You have the Infamous series. You have Ico. Amazing, amazing game. If you haven't played that, you have to. That is definitely a classic. Some Lego games. A good amount of Lego games, actually. You got the Batman, the Indiana Jones, and Star Wars Complete Saga, and along with Star Wars 3. Lost Planet. You have Loco Roco. Let's see. What else? You have Mega Man 9 and 10. Interested to see that they included that. You have all the Ninja Gaidens. So if you want to go nuts and rack your brain on playing those very, very hard games, you can. Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End. I haven't seen this in a very long time. Rage. The Ratchet and Clanks. So you get to play all of those. Red Deads. Got you covered. Resident Evil. So you have four, you have 5, 6. You also have Code Veronica, Operation Raccoon City, Revelations, and the Umbrella Chronicles. So good amount of Resident Evil games to choose from there. Sam and Max, Saint Rose 2. Let's see what else do they got. Space Ace, ooh, to go along with your Dragon's Lair. A huge fan of those. You have Street Fighter's Third Strike, some of the Strong Bad games. You have also Street Fighter 2 Turbo HD Remix and Puzzle Turbo as well, Puzzle Fighter. Siberia, here's a little thing for you guys to note, I worked on a version of this game for the Xbox way back in the day. So fond memories. You have The Darkness. Love these two games. Toy Story Mania, which I believe they turned into a ride now at Disney. Tron Evolution. XCOM. So yeah, Zombie Tycoon. Yeah, so those are the what you can see under the PlayStation 3 catalog. Now, under the PS1, PS2, PSP catalog, again, only available to premium subscribers. So let's sort this from A to Z, make it easier to look. So you have your Ape Escapes, your Dark Clouds, Fantavision, Hot Shots Golf, your Jak and Daxters, Oddworld, Primal, Red Faction. Here you have Resident Evil Director's Cut, Rise of the Kasai, awesome game, Jedi Starfighter, Bounty Hunter, Racer Revenge, Siphon Filter, Tekken, The Mark of Kree, such a great game, Wild Arms, War of the Monsters, Wild Arms 3, and Worms. So, interesting selection there. Doesn't seem that full or robust, if you were to ask me. And then here, they just like to categorize what are some of the Ubisoft classics that you can play under Extra. So, very, very cool stuff. So, let's go back. Now, premium. So we already covered essential. We already covered extra. Premium. These are the games that you can play on a limited time trial. And like I said, these are more of the newer stuff. So you have your Horizon Forbidden West. You have Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. Cyberpunk 2077. WWE 2K22. Uncharted Legacy of Thieves Collection, Hot Wheels Unleashed, Biomutant, Farming Simulator 22. So these are the games that you are allowed to play on a limited time trial. Now it says here, once you upgrade to premium, you get to play this game for a full 5 hours. So how good are you? Perhaps you could beat the game in 5 hours if you just, I don't know, binge it all the way through. But that's something that you could try out. And I believe that is the standard time trial you can play for each. Oh, no, it's not. Look at that. So each game will have their own specified time trial. So Tiny Tina's Wonderlands will be 2 hours only. Cyberpunk, you get to play this for 5 hours. A good amount of time there to test it out. WWE, we get to play for 2 hours. Uncharted Legacy of Thieves Collection, you get to try this out for 2 hours. Let's see, Biomutant, you get to try this out for 2 hours. There you go, 2 hour full game trial. So it looks like you're going to be able to try out these games in between 2 hours or 5 hours, depending on the title. I don't know what determines how long the trials are, but that's up to the discretion of, I'm sure, Sony and the developer there. Now, premium classics catalog, I believe I have already went through that. It's all the PS3. PSP, PS2 type of games. Let's see. Let's sort this. Let's see if there's anything that I may have missed. Well, yeah, there's some other stuff in here. So you have whatever these air combat games are. Let's see. Let's just go through these here to see if there's anything that was not included in the previous menu. Looks like for the most part, we have covered a lot of this stuff. Let's see. I don't know. let me know in the comments if there was anything that was missing that I didn't see before. I believe I said Lost Planet before. But yeah, it looks like these are all the same games that I already previously went over in the previous menu. So, but yeah. So let's go back. Cloud streaming. So they allow you to play certain games through their cloud streaming service. Now, it looks like what you're going to be able to do is play a lot of the games that we already covered through their cloud streaming service. Which a lot of you know, especially if you own a PS5, space can be very limited. So this could be a benefit of the cloud streaming, and you get to play some other games that you were not able to play regularly before because maybe you couldn't download it, or maybe you thought to yourself, you know what, I don't have the space, so I'm not even going to bother right now in playing this game or purchasing this game. So it's a good little added bonus that you can allow yourself to enjoy, really. So that being said there, so that's basically what you're going to get and what to expect with the new PlayStation Plus. Like I said, you know, if you want to go with the full shebang, you get to do so through the premium. And that gives you the game trials, the classics catalog, and cloud streaming with other benefits, you know, with the extra. At least it gives you additional games that you get to download and play. So definitely something to consider if that is something that you really, really want to do. What tier is best for you? It all depends on what it is you are looking to play and what you're looking for. If you are just fine with getting a certain amount of games every month that you could download for free under your subscription, then perhaps the Essentials is good for you. If you want additional games to add to your catalog or available to your library, then the extra may be good for you. But if you want the full shebang and you want to be able to, you know, test out some games, test drive them out before you buy them, if cloud gaming is something you really, really want to consider, and if you just want to relive a lot of classic games that you've played in the past, or maybe you've never had a chance to play them before, then premium could be something for you. In my opinion, I already own a lot of those games. You know, I never threw away or traded away or given away any of my old PlayStation consoles. I still have a lot of my previous library. Yes, it's true, I have to hook them up if I wanted to play. So there is a little bit of a convenience that it's all connected under one console, so to speak. And in time, they will be adding more games to the classics library, more games to the regular catalog, and so on and so forth. So I am curious as to see what other stuff they are planning to add in the future. But as of right now, in my own opinion and for my needs, I don't think premium is something that I would be interested to, you know, commit myself to at the current moment. But let's say I did, right? So if you hit this upgrade button, it will, you know, break down the tiers for you. But since I'm currently already in a subscription, like I said, I'm already subscribed to PlayStation Plus, it tells you how much more I have to pay today to upgrade to one of the two other tiers, which is very helpful. So let's say I wanted to go extra, right? I would only have to pay today $23.89 for the remaining 218 days of my subscription. And it does remind me that the next payment, when it's time to renew on the anniversary date, will be $99.99 for the next year. Now, if I wanted to go full shebang, I can upgrade to premium. And I would only have to pay today $35.83. Then it reminds me that in during my renewal, on the renewal anniversary, I would have to pay $119.99 for the next year. So, for the purpose of this video, let's say I want to upgrade to premium. And let's test drive it. Let's try it out. You know, $35.83 up until, as you could see all the way to the right, January 16th, a day before my birthday. That's not a bad thing, since I already paid for most of the subscription already. So I'm going to go ahead and upgrade to premium right now. Now, it reminds you again, due today is $35.83. Next payment will be $119.99 every 12 months, starting on 1/16/2023. And it says I'm upgrading from the Essential, which includes all that stuff, as you see there. And now Premium will give me classic catalog, fuller game catalog, game trials, and cloud streaming, along with everything else that I was getting previously, right? So let's do it. Then it reminds me one more time that I will be charged a one-time amount of $35.83 plus tax to upgrade to PlayStation Plus Premium. So let's accept. All right, as you can see, after I done all that, now I have PlayStation Plus Premium. All right, so brings me back to the screen that I was originally at. As you notice, the upgrade button is no longer there. So let us see what I can do first. So let's check out the game catalog. Now, the game catalog is available to play over their cloud service. So let us choose something. You know what? Let's choose Returnal. Let's see what happens if I could play this over the cloud. All right, so something interesting. It only gives me the option to download. So this is not something that you can play over the cloud according to what I'm seeing right now. So that's a bit of a bummer. So to save some time, let's go back here. Let's go to cloud streaming. And let's view games. Let's see what it's gonna tell me I can play over the cloud. All right, it still says Returnal, but no option to play over the cloud. What is up with you? It just says that I can download it, which I don't want to do because honestly, I don't have the room for it right now. Let's see. Let's see under featured. All right. Let's say I want to play Assassin's Creed Valhalla. There you go. So you will see a button right next to the game that says stream. This will allow you to play the game over the cloud. Now, it's a little disappointing that, you know, the previous screen, it makes you think you could play a lot of stuff through the cloud, but that doesn't seem to be the case. So I want to see if you can play over the cloud any of their current gen games. So let's see, for example, Demon Souls. Oh no, you cannot. What a bummer. So Demon Souls, you cannot play over the cloud. Returnal, you cannot play over the cloud. How about Spider-Man? Spider-Man Miles Morales, you cannot play over the cloud. That is really disappointing. How about Ghost of Tsushima? This, you cannot play, apparently, over the cloud. Let's see. Director's cut. Nope. How about the original Spider-Man? This, you cannot play over the cloud. Guardians of the Galaxy. This you can. This you could stream over the cloud. So that is, so far this has been very, very disappointing. How about Horizon Zero Dawn? This you could stream. So that's good. So is there a way to sort as to what you can play over the cloud? There is not. All right, note to Sony and PlayStation. It would be extremely helpful if you could create a proper section to let us know what we could stream over the cloud. God of War, you can. So that has been so far one of the more disappointing things about these tiers. Detroit Human, you could stream this. I already own it, so that's why it says I can play it. Shenmue 3, you could stream that as well. So very, very interesting. And again, very disappointing that the current gen games you cannot. Like I said, Returnal you can't, which is extremely disappointing. Miles Morales, you cannot. What happens if I choose Ultimate Edition? No, that's not included in any of these things. All right. Well, again, that is extremely disappointing. That is your womp womp moment. So, sucks to see that, right? But it says here, stream hundreds of PlayStation Plus catalog games. Now, if I scroll down, ooh, look, I found a bug. It will not let me continue. Scroll down. There's obviously other menus here. So, yeah, let's go back. Wow, big, big bug. All right. Not sure what's happening there. But let's give it a whirl. Okay, let's try to stream something. So, fine. I'll choose Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Here we go. Some little menu items. So what it's doing right now is that it is allowing the game to preload what it needs to preload on my console. Same thing pretty much happens when I tried cloud gaming on the Xbox. Oh, and here we are. Now, mind you, I do have a fast internet connection, so that could be a reason why it loaded this fast. Loading times will vary for a lot of you, so take that with a grain of salt. All right. Let's see if I could just hop into a quick game here, or at least something to load. Let's just say maybe later. Right. Taking its sweet ass time checking for add-ons. Again, it would have been easier and nicer if it just allowed me to stream Spider-Man. But no. Now, I wonder if it's because I'm streaming.
Hold triangle to enable menu narration.
No, I don't need...
Hold triangle enable menu narration.
Oops. Alright, brightness, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Alright. Because that's just painful. Okay, what I wanted to say is this cursor feels very laggy. So I don't know if that's because of the game or if that's because I'm streaming it. So I'm just going to choose the easiest settings because I just want to get through this to test this out. Let's enjoy. Now, I don't know how clear this looks like to a lot of you, but I know that when I've tried cloud streaming before on the Xbox, the video quality does feel like you're streaming something. You know, kind of like how you watch YouTube videos on a cell data network. Sometimes it looks like that. So this is what it kind of looks like right now, and that's kind of what to be is that is what to be expected when you do such a thing. And again, I do wonder if the load times have been increased because of streaming.
There you are.
Oh, look, I get to finally do stuff. Hey, look at me. I'm a little brat. There you are. I found this trinket. And I'm gonna go out now.
Eivor, here's a tune for you. Want to enliven your step?
Yes, everybody dance like fools. Dance for me. I'm the little shit. No, I won't do nothing for you. You creep me out. You're touching me in the wrong places. Don't touch my face. See, I told you. Oh no, now you're kissing me. I need an adult. Oh, I can dance. I can dance if I want to.
I'm ready to fight.
So nice having all of these hearty folk in our home.
Hey, yo. Come on, Eileen. Oh, I swear to heaven on this moment. You mean everything. Daddy, did I catch you cheating again? You're cheating on mommy.
So, you have the ring? Good.
This was worn by your grandfather in a battle on the North.
Or are you my mommy? Are you my real mommy? Yes. I'm not gonna listen. I'm gonna go out there and do it. That's right. Ah! Mommy's badass. At least I think that's my mommy. I can hardly carry this sword, but I swear I'll stab you with it. There, I did it. Yeah, here you could kind of see as the camera was panning that the quality is kind of like a buffered quality. That you wouldn't see, like when you stream a video. Again, I don't know if that's how it looked like in the real game, if you owned it. It's just something that I'm noticing. Alright, I get to finally do some stuff. As you can see, it is looking like there is some buffering going on. Better. If you can see, like, when I'm moving, the best way I can describe it is as if, you know, streaming a video on YouTube through your cell data. That's what it kind of feels like, or looks like to me. Again, not uncommon when you try to stream something over the cloud.
I feel better.
And I made it to the top. I could see my hut from here. Can I just jump? Into the water. Ooh, here we go. I can attack. Alright, let me see if I can sneak up behind this guy. It's been a while since I played an Assassin's Creed game. I want to try to murk this dude. Take that, you dammy. Alright, so that's basically the game here. And then when you get out, you return back to your menu and it shows up along with your other games here. And it gives you the option again that you can go ahead and stream it. Now, I'm going to go ahead and close the game. And I'm going to remove it from my home. Because I am honestly not planning to play this game again anytime soon. And the good thing again about streaming is that it doesn't really save anything to your console, so it really doesn't take up a lot of your storage space. So let's go back to here and let's go and check out some of the classic games. So let's see, how far back do we want to go? You know what, let us try Star Wars Starfighter. This is a nice classic, And what's great is that with the classics, you can also stream them. But this time, I am going to download it onto my console because it's only slightly under 2 gigs. So let's wait for that to download. Okay, now that we have it downloaded, again, I do have a fast internet connection, so it only took me like 3 to 5 minutes, roughly. So let's play this game, Jedi Starfighter. And the classic games, I'm assuming, and it's what it's looking like right now, is very similar to when you played classic titles on your PlayStation 3, on your PlayStation 2. Don't expect these to look phenomenally great. They're gonna look like how they looked like back in the day. But it's all done through their emulation. Accessing memory card. I don't got a memory card, you crazies. It's a PlayStation 5. Played this game in forever. So you know what? Instead of getting into things, let's just, again, I just want to demo how it plays. So let's not concern ourselves with the actual game.
I sense that you are eager to test the abilities of this prototype.
Yes, Master Tin, it is a fascinating ship.
Be patient. I am going to switch you to manual control in a minute, but before I do, I will activate your target tracker so you will be able to
find. Man, this really does bring back a lot of memories.
You should now see a target tracker on your HUD display.
Yes, I do.
Notice how the target tracker stays on my ship at all times. When I fly out of your view, the target tracker will turn to an arrow pointing you in the direction to fly to get to my ship. When you are ready, Master Gallia, I will release the autopilot control.
Well, release it already.
Good. Switching to manual control. Try to stay with me.
Now this
I got
is
it. Now this is pod racing. I'm gonna kill ya! Whee! Alright, so you get the gist.
You might notice
a nice classic game here. Now, if you wanted to stream one of the classic games, I'm sure it's not gonna be that terrible at all. If anything, it should be a lot easier because, you know, these aren't really heavy games compared to, you know, a PlayStation 4 or 5 titles. So in this case, let us try something that we could get into immediately. Let's try the Star Wars Racer. So I'm going to stream this. And let's take a look to see how long it loads for something that is much smaller. And look at that. It came up in no time. Again, smaller title, PlayStation 2 Classic. And your classic LucasArts opening logo. Aren't they cute? It's amazing how much more I love these guys later on, thanks to The Mandalorian. Alright, let's get into some gameplay. Yeah, I don't need to see. All right, so here we are. Also, Bulba's unlocked. Okay, so let's choose Anakin. Yeah, let's just do this. Let's just get in a game real quick to see how this plays out through the cloud. Yay, we're getting ready. Oh, there we go. I don't even know what the controls are. Whee! Come on, Annie. You can do it. Oh, I suck at this.
Better luck next time.
Whee! I'm gonna pass you. Oh, no. But, you know, again, as a classic game,
for all your collision and repair needs,
this, you know, the game plays fairly well. And I'm pretty sure that's what you're gonna experience the more classics that you try to stream over the cloud.
And look at Anakin Skywalker really bashing up the competition.
That's right, Robin's racing. Yeah, he's cheating. That's what he's doing. Ah!
What a finish!
Aw, I came in fourth. I suck. Alright, y'all, so that's pretty much it. That's your new PlayStation tiers and some examples of how, of what games you could play and how they will play, you know, download versus over the cloud streaming. So with all that being said, let me know what you guys think. Is this something that, you know, you're really interested in? Are you, what tier would you be interested in the most? Like I said, in my own opinion, I think premium for what is currently available right now for me is not worth the price tag. Even the extra tier for me is not worth it. I think the regular essential is good enough. I would love to see what happens in the next 3 months, 6 months, year to see what other games are available within the catalogs available there. The time trial stuff is interesting. I didn't go over any of that right now because I do have to download the games and that's going to take some time and all that. But, you know, that's a good feature, but it's basically extended demos of the games. You know, it would be great to see them include those games into the catalog eventually. But there's really not much, to be honest with you. I know they promise these tons and tons of games, but I just don't feel it, and I just don't see it right now. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think. Let me know what tier is right for you. And if you have any thoughts or questions or comments, of course, as always, don't forget to leave them in the comments section. Don't forget, you like what you see, you enjoyed this little review here, hit that like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Make sure to hit that notification bell to get notified for future uploads on the channel. Thank you again for watching. Stay cool, stay classy, stay safe, and I'll catch all of y'all next time. All right, peace.